In this tutorial, I am going to use polymorphism, which is you use a method as the virtual and another method as override. For this, we are going to start new project. And we use a console application and call it exercise. I am going to make a circuit which has two resistance, and we are going to make a program that those two resistances are going to be connected parallel or in series, and we are going to calculate the circuit's resistance. I am going to use a class . I am going to make it abstract class we call it circuit. And then we are going to use two variables, protected float R1, R2. And we are going to have a construct a property, and it is a public abstract float total, and we are going to use only get set, and then we are going to have a constructor public. This one must be public circuit float R1 and float R2, and this one must be R2. It must be circuit, and we are going to use this R1 equals to R1 and this R2 equals to R2, and then we are going to make another class parallel, inherits of circuit, and in this is I am going to use a method or a property override public float total and we are going to set R1 equals R2 equals value. It must be set and get. We are going to return R1 plus. R1 multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2 return R1 multiplied by R2 divided by R1 plus R2 is that it's a set and get over at public it is property and we are going to make another class Siri class Siri sorry inherits circuit we are going to use override public float total here I must define a method public parallel float R1 float R2 and nothing in that there is nothing in that because I have already calculated here. I don't understand this thing. His class. Is two it is constructor and it inherits of a base of R1 R2 and then here it is property, and we are going to set R1 equals R2 equals value. Why it hasn't? Must be. No, it is okay. And get return R1 plus R2. And then we are going to make a public story is constructed float R1 float R2, and it's inherits of base R1 and R2. Why? It is class variable. It's class, and this is class. Okay. Must be. Now it is okay, and here too. Now it is okay. Uko, and then we are going wrong. I cannot see what is wrong here. This must be something here, but I cannot see the reason of that. In the main, I am going to use something I cannot see the error. this one here, that is because it was now it is okay. Now it is okay. Now it is okay. Sorry, but now we are going to make our program, and in that I have class variables like static string s equals y, and then static float q0 and q1. And then in the main, you are going to ask console.writeLine. WriteLine. Please enter two resistors and variable R equals to console dot read line, and then we are going to use a condition if R of 0 contains that is slash okay, it must be split dot split, and we are going to use if it contains a division, then variable p is equals to r0 dot split. And then qnull equals float.parse of p of 0 divided by float.parse of p of 1. Else, we are going to use qnull equals to float dot parse r of 0. And then we are going to use another condition if R1 dot contains division, then we are going to use variable p equals to r1 dot split, and q1 is float P0 and divided by P1, else Q1 equals to copy V R1. After that, we are going to use parallel equals to new. We make an object of a class parallel, and we are going to use Q0 Q1, and we are going to use object from Seri equals to new Seri of Q0 and Q1. And then we are going to make a list of circuit and call it C equals to new list circuit. And their members is this parallel and this series. Then we are going to use for each loop, for each variable k in C, you are going to use console.writeLine, and we are going to use that expression before. Going to use this one, k dot get type, and it is a dot total equals to k dot total. And then we are going to use copy V, do you want to continue, yes or no, and then S equals to console. console dot read line. Okay, what is happening here is that we make two objects of both classes parallel and serie, and their arguments or their constructors has two parameters, and then we are going to make a list and of those objects, and then we are going to see any variable in C in our list. We are going to get the type, is it parallel or serie, and we are going to call the total total function and we are going to put and set those variables, and we are going to calculate, we are going to call the property total, and it's going to calculate. Now we are going to run. It's appearing soon. Two resistors, I am going to use 30 and 50. 30 and 50, and the parallel is 18.75, which is correct, and the serie is 80. Do you want to continue? Yes. It disappeared. Why? And I have forgotten to use while here. While s equals to y. Then we have this one. And down here, this one. Now we we are going to use 160, and the parallel is there and the serie is there. Yes, I am going to use 5 and 9, and this parallel and series. Okay, thank you for watching. See you in next tutorial.